is dead.
I actually didn't see this until you showed me this, but this is a clip that came out today from Briahna Joy Gray's podcast. This is an interesting. I mean, I hate to say it's a Kim Iverson L, but I mean, you know, this is kind of what we're getting out of these election takes. I'm telling you, these people are the worst when it comes to like electoralism. It's always the like. I'm not when I say like you know. I'm just saying, like, in general, like,
to be fair,
it tends to be like a pattern, you know, it's like Tulsi people and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Every concern or goal is a third party, then you'd vote Kennedy. You'd have to. That's the only person who's actually going to break the duopoly. Jill Stein's not going to break that duopoly.
My primary concern isn't voting a third party. I don't want to vote for a genocidal maniac.
No, right, but you want to break a duopoly, right? You want to break the duopoly. Well, the only person who's really got a viable shot at breaking that duopoly at this point is Kennedy. Jill Stein doesn't have that.
How? He doesn't have a party.
He doesn't, I mean, it doesn't matter.
He doesn't have a party.
You don't have to have a party.
It does matter. You have to build a party to have a...
To be fair, he does have a lot of money. He has a shit ton of money. And he's backed by all of these, like, MAGA, like, super PACs. So he's got funding by the billions. I mean, we're talking, like, David Sacks.
Mm-hmm.
That's who's behind him right now. And that's, I mean, if that's all you have left. That's what the campaign is, like, getting fed on. I'm not sure what the money is being spent on exactly. I mean, I'm sure you've seen a lot of what the results are this far into the election.
Mm-hmm.
I was impressed that he like he had like his own debate with like it felt kind of like I mean, I don't want to talk too much shit. I mean, I have a clear bias against
the permanent impact on whether or not you actually are able to have.
He could later.
Like Bernie Sanders?
Like Bernie Sanders like should all, have done. Like no, Bernie should have done.
But my point is that these candidates, they run these candidacies. They clearly have no interest in party development or doing anything outside of themselves. Haven't we learned that lesson already? And shouldn't we be invested in a party infrastructure over... it's not about Jill Stein as a human being, who I happen to like a great deal and respect a great deal. But it's about... the party. At what point are we going to learn this lesson and
well,
stop investing in
it.
These heroic... Why not?
Because there, it's just too it's too one-sided. I mean, it's too far left. I mean, the Green Party is just never going to attract on many issues. Like,
what does that mean?
It means.
Why did you say too far left?
I mean, practically all of.
Doesn't she identify as left?
Kim Iverson, I have no idea. She kind of just seems
she's
like.
So vague. Yeah.
Yeah, she. I don't think she really 100% knows either. But the thing is, like, if you want to see Kim Iverson L's, everybody go look up her interviewing Richard Wolf. It's a whole fucking interview of her taking L after L because she just can't fucking understand anything he's talking about. He's talking about like workplace democracy and collective ownership over the means of production. And she's like, I just don't think anyone will work hard. Like she just doesn't get it. Like it was just like her brain couldn't comprehend it. And I'm sitting there and Richard Wolf isn't a really good, he's not a great debater. I'll admittedly say that. He's way too charitable to people who disagree with him where he'll kind of like, just, he'll yes and whatever they're saying and kind of validate it and kind of fall over. I would basically say to her, like, listen, there's much more of an incentive to work harder if the fruits of your labor actually results in a direct improvement in your material conditions, in the way the company is doing, in your wages, in your benefits. If your fucking hard work, you actually see that improve, like the benefits you get from your labor, then you're going to work way fucking harder. Because as it is right now, you don't. You have a set salary, you got set benefits. Doesn't matter how hard you work, because we all know we're just working hard enough to not get fired. Because
they're
there's no...
Like, they're acting like everyone's salary is the same under communism, which is so not true. It's mm-hmm. not true.
That's another misconception. I hate arguing on Twitter with these soup heads who are just
what's
like...
What's that analogy that they use, like, where it's like... We're getting a little bit off topic, but like, what's that like little like analogy that they use, like where it's like under capitalism, everyone's like, you know, you make your own wealth and it's free. But then under like communism, it's all, everyone's the same. And someone like as like a fireman gets paid the same as like a janitor gets paid as like the same as like a PhD professor or something like that. Like, I don't,
first off,
know, shit like that.
First off, that's never been a thing. In
that's
anyone.
Never there's, happened. That's there's never been, fucking happened.
There, like, there's
I
never
wonder
been,
where like they're grabbing that from.
It's just propaganda. It's just it's deliberate misunderstanding. Because the first project of demonizing any kind of socialist system is you have to run lie after lie after lie, because you can't take the system on paper because it sounds better than capitalism. Because, spoiler alert, it fucking is. So the first thing you have to do is you have to fucking lie about it. Which is why you have these ridiculous soup-headed things. And because education in the West in general is so bad and biased and one-sided, people don't fucking know better. So they go, oh, okay, janitor getting paid the same as doctor, that makes sense. Which it doesn't, because... like, why would you invest
no one
so
does
much?
That.
Why would
no
you invest so much? Why would you invest so much more into becoming a doctor if you can just pick up a broom and make the same
Soviet
money?
Union
it makes
never
no
did that.
Sense. No,
the
they
Soviet
didn't.
Union never did that. They never
no,
did that.
No socialist country has ever done that
that's
ever.
Crazy.
It is the weirdest right,
let's,
fucking
let's,
lie.
Let's
keep going.
Them. Jill Stein is not, though. Jill Stein as a candidate is actually quite populist. Jill Stein is incredibly populist as a candidate. And she disagrees with her party all the time because the party has, you know, very leftist positions that is just, they're not going to attract the populist
wait a minute.
Middle.
There's
or even
disagreements
the populist
within
right.
the Republican Party. There are disagreements within the Democratic Party. Yeah. Most of the Republican Party thinks that you should give every last dollar in every American's bank account to Ukraine and litigate the war to the very end. Most of the Republican Party believes in a whole bunch of things that are not part of the populist wing that independents want to believe, want to pretend that the Republican Party really is. The Republican Party isn't, you know, Massey and Ron Paul. Like, that's just
right.
a fringe component. The same way that there's a lot of diversity within the Democratic Party. The point is, though, that on a very basic level, the Green Party adopts all of the populist frameworks that we say that we care about as people who formerly supported Bernie Sanders, right? Really
no.
basic bedrock issues like Medicare for all, which 69% of voters of Americans still want, wanting to have these greater labor protections, wanting the environment not to burn up into a crisp. I mean, it's not like a rocket science issue, right? Like, this isn't a close one in terms of which one of these parties, and I say that again, understanding that RFK Jr. doesn't have a party, which one of these parties actually represents the interests of most Americans.
Okay, the problem I have with Briahna here is that she's like framing it in a way where it's like Jill Stein versus RFK. Where we have to pick one.
The problem I have is that she's talking about how popular Medicare is, but I heard on the TV just the other week that we actually beat it. So I don't know why. This is very mixed messaging.
Yeah, we beat Big Pharma.
Yeah, we finally beat sorry, that's the funniest shit I've ever seen on TV. here's the cope.
The Green Party doesn't. I mean, it would be way more popular if it did. If anything, the Libertarian Party has a better shot at breaking through, you know, in the existing parties that are out there that are already kind of growing and popular. The Libertarian Party has a greater shot at becoming that third party potential.
When did that happen?
What is the Libertarian Party? I keep asking this. What are their actual policies? It just
they don't have one.
The Libertarian Party. Okay.
They invited Trump and then they all fighted each other over it. They invited Trump to their convention.
The Libertarian Party is literally just fucking Return to Monkey. That's it. That's the whole party.
It's just they don't have anything.
They might as well make their slogan "Unga Bunga, vote for us," because we're just going to leave society. We're going to pick up some fucking clubs. We're going to go ride wargs in the desert. Like, they don't fucking stand for anything. They don't even know what they support. They're just like, remove government, and they... You defeat every single libertarian argument by just saying, okay, feudalism. And that's it.
Just look at Javier Milei. Look at Argentina. It's great.
I mean, but they've got their own ideological problems that people are uncomfortable with. You know, the fact that, you know, what is the ideology other than no government for anything?
They don't want a government.
Oh, anybody. Shit! Okay. Yeah. So here's the cope I'm hearing about this. You've got these seemingly independent media voices who are like, they're basically kind of forcing you to pick one of these like non-duopoly options, and they're talking about breaking the duopoly and all this other shit, but they're still trying to get you invested in the system. They're still trying to get you to buy in to electoralism, where I'm sorry, I'm going to burst a lot of bubbles here, a lot of third party bubbles too. I know a lot of y'all were frothing at the mouth when it came to Cornell, and a lot of people are frothing at the mouth when it comes to Jill. But the reality is, we don't live in a fucking democracy in North America. We don't, because first past the post voting isn't democratic, okay? The majority of people are always going to be forced into these slots, which is, I have to hold my nose and vote for the party that I don't think, the party that I think is marginally better than the other party that I think is worse. The majority of people are always going to get scared and get forced into that. And so all you have to do is make one side get progressively shittier, and you can just shove your country in a direction that benefits the rich and powerful and fucks over the workers. That happens in every single capitalist country across the board. You always fall into that dilemma, and there isn't a way around that. You can't vote your way out of that dilemma. That's the problem. That's why I'm sorry, like, third party, if you're going to vote for third party, do it, but understand it's a masturbatory vote. You're voting to make yourself feel better. That's essentially what you're doing. And if you vote for the duopoly, you're essentially validating the system too. So you're really fucked either way, right? That's just how I feel about it. But everybody's talking about.
I do think if we had like a 3% voter turnout in the United States, like, that'd be really like crazy. But that's just a theory. I'm not suggesting don't vote. I'm just saying, you know, do what you have to do. I mean, maybe throw it at Jill Stein. I did it in 2016, but I would consider myself like sort of liberal until like maybe like 2020.
I'm not saying don't vote. I'm just saying don't get your hopes up. Don't spend all of your time.
Yeah, no, it should be
obsessing,
like,
over this shit.
Yeah, we kind of get like hyper focused in this shit. I mean, this, it's kind of thrown in your face within the election cycle, and you can kind of see it, like, how like the Biden, how everyone's paying attention to like the Biden implosion right now.